software demonstrations, but first I wanted to talk a little bit about the software that I'm going to be demonstrating. The software that I'm choosing to demonstrate all of the theory that I talk about in GIS class is the ESRI ArcGIS software suite. I do want to make you aware of the fact that ArcGIS is available only for Windows. There is no version for the Mac operating system, so if you're running the Mac platform, you're going to have to put bootcamp on the machine or run Parallels so you can install ArcGIS on the Windows side of the machine. I would also like to let you know that the ArcGIS software package does have some fairly robust system requirements, so be sure you check those for whatever version of the software that you're planning on installing and compare them to the system specifications for your computer. Just be aware that GIS functionality can be very computationally intensive, and so if you're trying to install this on a lightweight laptop like a netbook that you primarily use for internet browsing and light word processing, you're probably not going to be able to do it. Even if you are able to install it on a lighter weight system, it may not run very well. So please be aware of that as you're looking for a computer to install the software on. ArcGIS is a software suite that actually contains several different programs. The primary two that I use in an introductory GIS course is ArcMap, which is for displaying and analyzing two-dimensional GIS data. This is the program that you will be using most frequently. And ArcCatalog, which you'll be using almost as frequently, for managing all of your GIS data. We use a specialized program to manage GIS data. We don't use Windows Explorer, for example, to manage GIS data the way you might use it to manage Word documents or Excel spreadsheets. That's very important, and we'll talk more about that later. Then there is also ArcScene, which is used for three-dimensional analysis and display, and I talk about that a little bit in Introduction to GIS as well. I gave a lot of thought to what software would be best to demonstrate the concepts that I talk about in the Introduction to GIS course, and ultimately I did settle upon the ESRI ArcGIS software suite. This is a professional software package. It's very powerful. It is a complex software package, but the reason that I chose to use this software package for demonstration is because it's very important for GIS professionals to get exposure to this software suite. There are many different software packages for doing GIS analysis. And as I tell my students, it's essential that you learn a variety of software packages. There are people who think that ESRI's software is all there is in the GIS world, and this is not true. There are many different software packages, and part of a complete education in GIS or becoming a GIS professional is getting to know a lot of different software packages so that you understand the benefits and disadvantages of different software packages, what the capabilities of different software packages are in order to most efficiently accomplish the tasks that you need to accomplish. Because it really is the case that when all you have is a hammer, everything starts to look like a nail. So if all you know is the ESRI software, then that's all you can ever use to solve your problems. And that's not a good situation to be in. However, it's essential, because this is an industry standard software package, to be familiar with it. And so I have chosen to use this software package in my entire Introduction to GIS course. When I'm teaching at the university, students do two semesters with the ESRI software. We do the Introduction to GIS course with the ESRI software. This allows students to get familiarity with all the theory of GIS, but allows them to have a very powerful software package they begin to go ahead and get to know, go ahead and gain familiarity with it and its basic functionality. Then in the second semester course, we're able to really get into the software package and learn about what it's really capable of. And we can really, really begin to get into the kinds of stuff this software package can do. I think you need two semesters with this software package in order to get to that point with it. But then it's fantastic that also at the university, in other courses, we use other software packages in order to broaden everybody's horizon and gain exposure to other packages. But I'm going to be using this one for this software demonstration. You can go to ESRI's website and you can get a free trial of the software. Also, if you get a tutorial book for a particular version of the software, which I highly recommend, it also comes with trial versions of the software so you have it to experiment with. I will be using ArcGIS 10.2 which right now is the current version of the software. But I don't want to get too caught up on that, because the concepts that I'm going to be doing in these software demonstrations are not going to be hugely dependent upon any particular version of the software. So if you don't have the latest version, that's okay. If you're running a different version in a computer lab at school, or if you're using a slightly different version in a work environment, you should still be able to get what I want you to get out of these software tutorials. It's just a fact of life that software versions change, and that's why I recommend, especially if you are very new to GIS, making sure that you pick up a tutorial, a workbook created by the software vendor for the particular version of the software that you are running. Some people, when a button has moved or some functionality has changed a little bit, are capable of rolling with the punches and just figuring out the functionality, or searching it, doing a web search or something for where the buttons move to. And ultimately, that's where everybody needs to get to. But especially if you're starting out, some people really like to know, okay, this button, and then this button, and then this button, and make sure they know exactly where things are. The software vendor will be able, will have tutorial books for you, and that's why I'm not terribly concerned about updating the software demonstrations that I'm going to be doing for every single software version released. It's just not that important for what I'm going to be showing you. I would like to point out that in addition to this software suite actually being a collection of several different programs, that it is also available on several different license levels. For instance, we have Basic, Standard, and Advanced, and if you go down here, you will see all the different tools. You'll be able to compare the different tools and functionality that are available on the different license levels. So this is something to watch out for as you move on. Perhaps, for instance, you're working in a school's laboratory or at a work office, and you may be seeing somebody doing something that you can't do. Well, it may be because you are on a lower license level than what that other person is. If you want all of the functionality, then you have the advanced license level. We have standard and also basic license level. So please do be aware of that. If you are downloading the free trial, I believe you are able to download the advanced version and have it all. All right, so please keep all of that in mind as we go forward. I hope we're able to get everybody to the point where everyone can roll with the punches as different elements of different software packages changes, because I'm sure that next year we'll be looking at ArcGIS 10.3 and then 10.4 and 10.5. But we're going to try to stay with information in these software demonstrations that will be valid for many different versions of the release of the software. All right, let's get started.